Variables, level 2. Alright, let's jump straight into some examples. Tell whether each statement is true or false, and explain your reasoning. 7 times 5 is equal to 20 plus 15. Alright, so the first thing we need to do is, we need to simplify each side of the expression to be able to compare them. The left-hand side simplifies to 35, and the right-hand side simplifies to 35. Since 35 is equal to 35, this is a true statement. How about the next statement? 3 plus 3 does not equal 3 times 3. Once again, we need to simplify each side of the statement in order to appropriately compare them. The left-hand side simplifies to 6, and the right-hand side simplifies to 9. 6 does not equal to 9. This is true. Let's try the next statement. 4 times 0 is equal to 0 times 6. Again, we need to simplify each expression to appropriately compare them. The left-hand side simplifies to 0, and the right-hand side simplifies to 0. And it turns out that 0 is equal to 0. This statement is absolutely true. Alright, let's try the next statement. 8 divided by 1 does not equal 1 divided by 8. Like always, we need to simplify each side of the expression. The left-hand side simplifies to 8, and the right-hand side simplifies to 1 over 8. So the statement simplifies to 8 does not equal to 1 over 8. And this is, once again, true. 8 does not equal 1/8. How about the next statement? 54 times 1/2 does not equal 54 times 0.5. We need to simplify each side of the statement to compare them. The left-hand side simplifies to 27, and the right-hand side also simplifies to 27. Remember that the decimal 0.5 can be rewritten as 1/2. So the statement simplifies to 27 does not equal 27. This is absolutely false. 27 does not equal 27. 27 actually equals 27. So this statement is false. Alright, now let's work on simplifying numerical expressions. Simplify the expression, the quantity 8 minus 3 plus 3. The expression in the parentheses is simplified first. So doing that, we have that 8 minus 3 is equal to 5. And we add 3 to the result, which simplifies to 8. Alright, so let's simplify the expression 5 times the quantity 11 plus 1. Once again, the expression within the parentheses is simplified first. So we have that 11 plus 1 is equal to 12. And then we multiply that by 5, which is equal to 60. Alright, let's try the next expression. 6 plus the quantity 12 divided by 3. We worked with the parentheses first, so we get that 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4. We add that to 6, which is equal to 10. Try the next one. 29 minus the quantity 0 times 9. 0 times anything is always equal to 0. So that this simplifies to 29 minus 0, which is equal to 29. Alright, let's try the next example. Simplify the quantity 12 times 10 minus 2 times 11. So here, we have an expression with two parentheses. So the left-hand side reduces to 120, and the right-hand side reduces to 22, and now we subtract these two quantities. And now we have 120 minus 22, which simplifies to 98. Let's try the next one. Simplify the quantity 40 divided by 10 divided by 1 times 4. So here, once again, we simplify the expressions within the parentheses. So the left-hand parentheses simplifies to 4, and the right expression within the parentheses simplifies to 4. So now we need to simplify 4 divided by 4, which is equal to 1. Now let's practice evaluating expressions. Evaluate each expression if x equals 1, y equals 2, and z equals 3. Notice that we have three different variables, and each variable has a corresponding value. The goal is to use these expressions to substitute the values of these variables into the following expressions. Okay, so first expression is 5x. The variable here is x, so we need to substitute x with the corresponding value, in this case it's equal to 1, and always, we use parentheses to substitute any variables. This is going to be key as we work with more complicated algebraic expressions. So now we evaluate the expression. So 5 times 1 simplifies to 5. Let's try the next variable expression, x times y. So once again, we substitute each variable. In this case, we have two different variables, x and y. So x is actually equal to 1, and y is equal to 2. So substituting expressions, we have the following. And now we simplify the expression, and it turns out that it's equal to 2. Let's try the next variable expression, 3y minus 6. So here, notice that we have a parentheses. We need to work on these expressions first. So first of all, we need to substitute the variable, in this case y, with 2. And as always, make sure you use parentheses when you're substituting. So now we have 3 times 2, which signifies to 6. And then 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Let's try the next expression. The quantity 3 times z minus the quantity 4 times x. So here we have 2 parentheses. We need to work on each one before we subtract them. So first of all, we need to substitute z with 3, again using parentheses, and substitute x with 1. Left-hand side signifies to 9, and the right-hand side signifies to 4. Subtracting these two values, we have that the final answer is equal to 5. Let's try the next expression. 1 half times the quantity z minus x. We need to work with the values in the parentheses first. So we substitute each value, and we have 3 minus 1, which is equal to 2. And then 2 times 1 half is just equal to 2 over 2, which reduces to 1. Let's try the next expression. Signify the quantity z plus y over z minus y. We substitute each variable with the appropriate value. So we have the quantity 3 plus 2, which is equal to 5, over the quantity 3 minus 2, which is equal to 1. 5 over 1 reduces to 5. Let's try the final variable expression. Signify the expression 8 plus the quantity 9 times x times y, or 9xy. We need to substitute the variables with the appropriate value. In this case, x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. So we evaluate the quantity in the parentheses first. That expression signifies to 18, and we add 8 to that. So we have that the final answer is equal to 26. Alright, in our next video, we will learn how to signify expressions with and without grouping symbols.